It's Jason Abraham, the shadow teacher, and June 25th, 2020, I had my first UFO sighting, and I had profound UFO contact as something came through from another dimension and connected with me and other people that night. And again, that event changed my life. It shattered the paradigms of my belief system of what was possible, of what was real. And it put me on this road of obsession, an obsession with understanding what that was. And can I talk to it again? And before I had that contact, I practiced, one of my mentors shared a yogic system called a system of Caucasian yoga, which is a system of sun yoga, sun arcanes, they call them. And I've been practicing that for months straight, on and off pretty much for years before that, but consistently for the months leading up to that contact. And the sun arcanes, again, their intention is, or what supposedly cultivates, is different psychic abilities, clairvoyance, clairaudience, clairsentience. And so I've kept that practice up. And then I was called to start practicing remote viewing as a regular practice, just studying in the UFO communities and just kind of looking at some of these other practices that people who've had contact have engaged in to connect with that non-human intelligence. So I started a consistent remote viewing practice a year ago, and I've stayed with that. And like with any practice, when you stick with it, you get better at it and you deepen your understanding of it. So what I've learned, a few things I've learned from remote viewing, is that A, anyone can do it if they practice it, if they practice the correct protocol and work on it on a consistent basis. And also, this power, again, the psychic ability that everyone has, it doesn't work if your higher self senses any kind of manipulation, whether that be your ego, your desire to want to show off, to feel important and show off to other people, or someone else trying to manipulate you to use that power for their own ends. At least through me, it hasn't worked. Anytime someone's tried to manipulate me to RV something for them, I haven't been able to do it. And same thing, if I wanted to RV something that seemed sensational, seemed just something, oh man, if I RV this and make a YouTube video on it, my channel's gonna blow up, never has worked. And I thought, I read the book, There Is a River, which is about Edgar Cayce. And I remember in that book, there was a similar account with his psychic abilities. He was known as the sleeping psychic. He would go into a trance, and would someone with no education, Edgar Cayce had no formal medical training, no education, but he could diagnose and feel people's medical issues and prescribe remedies that worked most of the time. But again, when he was being manipulated, or whether it be egoic or manipulation from the outside, his gift didn't work. It's like the higher self said, no, you can't do that to me. The thing that moved through him would not allow it. And I've, again, in my RV, my remote viewing practice, I've found this to be the truth. I can always remote view objects that don't seem to matter. And again, this is kind of how the CIA and the intelligence agencies work. Like with their psychics, most of their trials and their tests were things that just didn't really matter. Like viewing a stapler in another room, or viewing a pencil in another room. Like, you can do that all day because there's not really anything that comes out of that. But when you start to get into something that's going to have more of a consequence on the life process, whether it be yours or someone else's, then, you know, again, what I found, something bigger steps in. And I'm sure there are bypasses to it. I'm sure, like the dark arts, those who are in that, they figured out the bypasses. But those who work in the light, again, it's a reminder that we are co-creators, that it is not our will, it's our unique personality, that something bigger moves through. And this is yet another reminder of that. That's all I got today. Just interesting food for thought for anyone who practices this or is curious about it. And I'll continue to dig into my practice, and when I have something relevant to share, and when God, Great Spirit, Oversoul, wants to share something through me, I always say yes. And I will see you on the other side.